fellow beauty finders, this is Matthias Allen. Thanks for clicking on this new video. So for those of you that are new to my channel, I am going to do makeup tutorials, makeup hauls, product reviews, and sit down interviews with fellow makeup artists in Los Angeles working in the entertainment business just as I am. So I am so excited to bring you this week's First Face Friday, in which I worked with a client on Halloween and gave him a complete transformation. He wanted to be completely unrecognizable, and so we turned him into an old man. So stay tuned, I'm going to show you exactly how to make that happen. So I decided to use this spray Halloween color in his hair because I wanted him to completely transform. He told me that he wanted to go to the club and not have any of his friends recognize him. So when you're using these spray colors, you really have to be careful not to get it on the skin. So that's why I used a little bit of scotch tape around his hairline. And then around the sideburns, I painted it on with a little paintbrush to be extra careful around his ears. Now I'm using this green marble sealer on his skin prior to any makeup application. The other thing that he really wanted was something that was going to last no matter how many people touched him. So starting with that is fantastic. Now this old age stipple is a trick that we use in film because it's actually a very subtle change to the skin. You have to do it in multiple layers, but it is a great way to make the skin look very, very rough and textured. And the way that it works is you lay it down and then you stretch the skin out, you dry it as fast as possible with a blow dryer is how I'm doing it. And then when you let the skin go, which you'll see right here, the skin is much crepier and more wrinkly. Do you see that? Leave a comment down below if you actually see the difference. So you want to concentrate this product on the crow's feet area, on the forehead, around the jaw and the chin like I was doing. And then you want to set it all with a loose powder. I like the Kryolan waterproof loose powder as a base. Now next I'm going to take these two Ben Nye pencils in a light taupe and a brown, and I'm going to start adding the wrinkles and the texture into the skin. I'm actually asking him to furrow his brow and kind of create the buckling of the skin with his own muscles, and that way I can use that as a diagram to just fill in and create more shadow and pigment with the pencils. Now using the pencils alone would be fine if you're just going to go to a party for an hour or two, but I like going over it with Skin Illustrator. Now Skin Illustrator is a product that is alcohol activated, meaning you don't add water to make the pigment happen, you add alcohol. I like using paint brushes with this. Paint brushes from Michaels or Amazon would be great, and I like ones that have a very small tip so that I can create very, very, very small structures. Now by going over this whole pencil diagram with these Skin Illustrators, which are alcohol based, I create something that is going to be completely budge resistant, sweat proof, waterproof, everything. I mean, Luke could literally have jumped into a pool after this was all done and none of his makeup would have come off. I think that's one of the most important things for any client, whether it's a celebrity that I've worked on or a bride that I've worked on or a Halloween client. I mean, I've been doing this for so long and I've figured out and been taught so many tips and tricks that making the makeup last through no matter what happens is why I'm hired to do these kinds of looks. Now this kind of a stippling sponge is great. It adds demarcations in the face and age spots very quickly. And then I put a layer of a silicone based foundation over the top. A very, very light layer just to kind of soften the alcohol based pigments, which do look very dark before I layer it on with foundation. But then now they look like they're just coming from within the skin and they're more natural. Now I'm adding a little bit of powder shadow and highlight around the areas of his face where the foundation took a little bit too light. I'm also contouring around his hairline and on his jaw and under his neck. I'm going back in with the pencil and doing another layer of both the pencil and the Skin Illustrator as well. And then I do a little bit more of the old age stipple, and there you go. That's the final look. If you guys have found this video and you'd like to hire me for your own special Halloween look, please email me and I'll send you my rates. I hope you guys enjoyed this step-by-step makeup demonstration. It was a pleasure to bring you my knowledge and my experience. As always, I would love for you guys to stay with me and subscribe to my channel by clicking on this link right down here at the bottom. I do 3 weekly videos, Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, so please, please, please stay tuned. Follow me on all social media, including Periscope, where I do live feeds from makeup sets and studios and film locations at Mathias for Makeup on Periscope as well. And click on one of these other 2 videos before you go and stay with me here on my channel. Remember to leave me a comment or any questions you may have down there in the description box, and click on the thumbs up tab if you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.